under the lights this evening as we get you set for another edition of baseball on MLB Network. Tonight, the opener of a three-game series between the Cleveland Indians and the Cincinnati Reds. It's Interleague Baseball on MLB Network. Tyler Molly, a California-born right-hander, is on the mound. What do you have for us on him, Danny?
Well, Matt, you hate to go into game thinking that you're going to have to get the bullpen involved, but you may have to with this guy on the mound. He's not known for going very deep in the games. Very rarely does he go six innings or more, so this very well could be one of those Johnny Holstaff days.
So now into the box is Cesar Hernandez. He'll get us started in this one under the lights. The 1-1 is strike two, swinging. A cool 47 degrees tonight at first pitch. Here comes the 1-2. Right side. And this will get through into right, and he's aboard with a single.
You don't see that too much in today's game. Most guys, it doesn't matter what the count is, they're looking to line them, drive the ball out of the ballpark. Not the case here. Good two-strike adjustment and able to punch a ground ball through a hole for a single.
To the plate now, Harold Ramirez. Oh, and he was fooled that time on the pitch away as he went around for strike two. A 1-2. Nobody out, runner on first. Neither guy willing to give in, and the at-bat will continue. Working for the punch out and the offering. To two balls and two strikes now.
Boy, not what you want coming out of the gate as a pitcher, right? You don't want to have to show all of your pitches this early on in the game, but that's a quality at bat. And what does it make you do as a pitcher? You have to use a lot of your pitches, and the more pitches a hitter sees, the better chance they have to make good contact.
On a rope to the second baseman, and the runner gets back. No double play.
Batting third, the third baseman, Jose Ramirez.
In now for Cleveland, Jose Ramirez. First chance for him here with a runner at first and one gone. Runners on first with one down. Fastball taken, but that gets the zone for a strike. The 1-2. Swinging a ball hit on the ground.
You can really tell they're trying to keep the ball in on this big slugger right here.
Is that an effort to keep him from getting extended, do you think?
Yeah, I think that's the idea, Matt. But he might spin to win if he starts looking for it in there.
The next 1-2 pitch. Hit hard on the ground towards second. To second for one. Relay to Votto's in time at first, and it's a double play. Side retired. So no runs on one base hit, no errors, and no one left on. And now the Reds will get their first opportunity. No score. Zach Plesac gets the ball for the Indians in this one. Dan, any thoughts?
Hey, Matt, this guy has what we call Uncle Charlie. What's that? That's the 12-6 curveball. Simply look at your watch and look at the 12 and look at the 6. This guy throws old school. They call it a straight downer. However you want to call it, a 12-6 hook. This guy has one of the best ones in the game right now.
Nick Castellanos at the plate now. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. The 1-1. Hit weakly on the ground to short. He's right there. And that's the first out.
Batting second, the left fielder, Jesse Winker.
Next, here is Jesse Winker. His career numbers against this pitcher. He's 0 for 5. Now the 2-1. Yanked on the ground down the line. And he dives, but he can't make the play. It lands foul.
Put that in the memory bank. First time he breaks out a curveball right there, and it's a pretty good one.
And another foul ball.
I know that fastball registered at about 92, 93, but I guarantee you it looked about 4 to 5 miles an hour faster than that for this offensive player. After coming off a curveball, the old push the throttle and pull it is being used.
So he chased out of the strike zone on that one. Jesse Winker becomes out number two this inning. Into the box now, Joey Votto. Count moves to a ball and two strikes now. Got him swinging, and that will end the inning. 1-2-3 go the Reds. Still no score. And that'll bring in Franmil Reyes. He brings a hit streak that currently sits at 6 games entering play. And that's high and off the plate, 2-1. And guys, as we take a look at the Reds entering play here tonight, they've been playing some pretty good baseball of late as they've won 6 of their last 8 games.
Yeah, Matty, we had a saying in Texas, hit or get left behind. And that's exactly what this team did in their last game. Scored a bunch of runs, but good approach at the plate, working the ball to all gaps, line to line. This team swung the bats well. I'm going to be looking for that again in this one.
3-1. Now a swing and a fly ball. And no one will track it down. Now the payoff pitch home. Hit hard on the ground at first. And he'll take this to the bag himself, and the leadoff man set down to start the second.
The left fielder, number 9, Eddie Rosario.
Ready now is Eddie Rosario. His prior history versus this arm, he's 1 for 4. Here's the 1-1. Below the zone, a swing and a miss.
That's just a great pitch right there. Great execution. He just got that hitter to think that pitch was knee-high. Nasty diving out of the zone.
Nasty breaking ball swung on in the dirt. Barnhart corrals it, and the throw to first is there to record the second out. Two down, no one on base. And the next to bat will be Josh Naylor. No score here as we play inning number 2. Fouled away. In tight with the slider, 2-2. The pitch. pulled toward right center field. Senzel makes the play, and the side is retired. Down in order go the Tribe. We'll go to the bottom of the second, no score. So now the Reds' cleanup hitter, Eugenio Suarez. He's off to a good start at the plate, the average coming in just under 300. The 1-1. Turned on that one and crushed it, just pulled it a little foul. Now here's the pitch. And a good bite to that slider as he swings through it for the first out of the inning.
Really good late bite on that slider right there. The best ones have that late action that just darts at the last minute. They're so tough to get the bat on, and when you've got that good slider going, it's a great strikeout pitch.
Standing in now, Mike Moustakas. He loses him on ball four.
Batting fifth, the center fielder, Nick.
In now for the Reds, Nick Senzel. And he's been swinging the bat really well in April. He's got that average up over 350 to start the new season.
What a terrific season this guy's having. Up near the leaders in batting average. Without a doubt, the highest average and the best hitter on this team.
Oh, it's hit to third. Five. Hernandez at second. The relay on to first. The double play, and the side is retired.
Boy, oh boy.
Clearly enjoying their time here at the ballpark, as are we. More in a moment on this Friday night. You're watching MLB Network. All set for the start of the inning, and that'll bring Andrés Giménez into bat. The 1-1 home. And a fastball is hit on the ground towards short. Throw to first in time, and the leadoff man is gone to start the third. And with that, we give you a look here at what's happening in the race in the National League Central. Next, it'll be Austin Hedges. In his career against this pitcher, he's 2-for-4. And it's 2 balls and 2 strikes now.
I love everything this pitcher's got working right now. He's got presence. He's got great body language on the mound. He's got fastball command and a nice early feel for his off-speed stuff.
Payoff pitch home. Popped him up. Votto in foul ground. He's got it, and there are two down now. So here now is the pitcher, Zach Plesac. No offer on that one. 2 balls and a strike.
You certainly know he's not trying to work around the pitcher. But sometimes the hardest thing to do is to throw a strike to a guy that you know won't swing the bat.
In the air to left. Winker is there, makes the catch, and the side is retired. Indians go down 1-2-3. Home half of the third coming up. No score. Now for Cincinnati, Jonathan India, and he's looking to get it going. Off to a bit of a slow start this year. up and in here as he had to bend out of danger.
Well, that'll wake everyone up. Anytime you buzz the tower like that, there's reason for people to start getting a little bit edgy.
Swung on and lifted in the air to left center. Rosario arranged to his left as he tracks this one down in left center for the first down. And now here is Tucker Barnhart in his career versus this pitcher. Just a couple of matchups, no hits and two at-bats. One and two now as that one's fouled off. Into the corner and slicing foul. Now a swing and a miss on a pitch that's inside and hits him, but it won't matter. It's out number two regardless.
The pitcher.
Next, the hit will be the pitcher, Tyler Molly. This guy's still looking at a zero in the hit column. From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. Swing and a line drive. And the Reds have their first hit of the game.
Hey, I'm not surprised right here. This pitcher mixed in a knock. Playing in the National League, he gets way more opportunity to work on his craft from the offensive side of the ball. NL pitchers definitely have an advantage in these interleague games.
Nick Castellanos now. He gets a shot to hit here in the inning following the two-out single.
Yeah, and that hit might not amount to much, but anytime you can extend an inning and give a guy with plenty of pop a chance to swing it, the outlook of an inning changes dramatically.
Grounded back up the middle, reined in. The easy way to Hernandez to retire the side. Reds leave one. We'll head to the fourth, still scoreless. All set for the start of the fourth, and that'll give way to the veteran second baseman, Cesar Hernandez.
I know we're not seeing a lot of offense in this one, but there's still some game left. I'm looking to see these guys, both offenses, make some notable adjustments at the dish and try and scratch a few runs across.
Still all zeros in the run column here in the fourth inning. Dan, does this continue or does somebody score here?
I think this continues for a while, Matt. Both of these pitchers are throwing very well, throwing strikes, having good command of their off-speed pitches. This is going to be one of those low-scoring affairs.
Throw to first in time, one gone here in the fourth. Now to bat, Harold Ramirez. Hit it hard, but lined out in his first at-bat.
Yeah, he hit it hard. That's all you can ask. You can't control the result sometimes, Matty. Just unlucky with the placement.
Now the 2-1 pitch. Doesn't hit the target. It's ball three.
Part of the order on deck, so keeping this two-hole hitter off the bags is always important.
No runs, just one hit. No errors to this point for the Indians. And that's outside. He lost him ball four.
Well, in a scoreless game, you want to do anything you can to jumpstart your offense. With the speed of this guy on first, don't be surprised if he gets the green light here.
And now in the box, Jose Ramirez comes into this at-bat 0-for-1 in the ballgame. Breaking ball that time that misses out of the zone.
Defense has got to be on their toes right here. 3-2 count. Runner on first has got some serious wheels. You know he's probably being put in motion.
Now the payoff pitch home. Full count still. Ramirez leads off first with one away. And that's into the corner, a foul ball in right. Still three balls and two strikes. The eighth pitch of the at-bat. And he can only battle for so long as he's finally set down here after an 8-pitch at-bat.
The white fielder, number 32.
Striding in for the Indians, Franmil Reyes. He's 0-for-1 thus far. Ready to deal. Here's the 1-1. Fouled off. Set to deal on a ball and two strikes.
Too much bite
on the breaking ball that time as it's well off the outside. Never tempted to swing at that ball down low. It's ball three.
Well, this has been a good at bat. He's now worked the count full to 3-2. It allows the runner on first to be on the move with two away.
Now the payoff pitch home. And a good at bat that time as he lays off for ball four. And as a result, that'll move a runner up into scoring position now with two away.
He did not want to let the hitter off the hook with two outs. And now he's got a runner in scoring position to deal with.
Digging in next, Eddie Rosario, 0-for-1 for him here in this one. The 1-1. And he fouls this one off. Ready with the 1-2.
Hey, usually the second time through the order, you start seeing an incorporation of some more off-speed stuff. But this guy's locating, feeling really good about his fastball. Two back-to-back.
2-2 the count. Two and two. Here it is.
For the guy on the mound, this is one of those innings where nothing comes easy. He's thrown a bunch of pitches, and this AB hasn't been any different. Definitely laboring at the moment.
On the eighth pitch of the at-bat is the one that finally does it as he wears him down, and the inning is over. Clearly fired up to work out of that jam. We're back to Friday Night Baseball on MLB Network after this. Ready to go in the bottom of the fourth. And next to bat will be Jesse Winker. Two and one. In front of the changeup, and he can't keep it fair. Two strikes on him now. The 2-2. Spear got a hop, and there's one down now. So bases are empty with one out now, and standing in is the on-base machine, first baseman Joey Votto. Just one hit apiece for both of these clubs. That's lifted the other way out to left. Rosario is right there as he'll put it away without much problem for the second out. So here is Eugenio Suarez. The 1-1. And it's to 2-2 now with the bases empty and two gone here in the inning.
We just saw a fastball right there. I would not be shocked if he tries to get this guy to go fishing right now.
We'll have to press pause as that's strike three to retire the side. Reds are down in order through four. Still tied, nothing. Now that brings up Josh Naylor. Flied out in his first at-bat, so make him 0 for 1 so far. The 1-1. They really bunch him up on that one as he swings and misses for the first out. That was a nasty-looking slider that time.
Yeah, that was really well executed, Matt. A classic strikeout pitch. You think it's fastball middle in, then it starts bearing in on your back leg, and unless you hit it out front, there's nothing much you can do with that.
At the plate now, Andrés Giménez. And he misses low here, so the count goes to 3-1. Bases are empty, one man out. Full count, 3-2. Now the payoff pitch home. On the ground, softly towards second. Gonna be a tough play. And that's the second out. Into the box, Austin Hedges popped into foul ground his last time up.
Yeah, this one's going to upset him for a little bit. You make the pitcher work the way he did right there, and that's the end result. That one sticks with you for a while.
Back up the middle, Senzel brings it in. So only the second hit he's given up tonight.
Yeah, man, he's locked in and pretty dominant since the first. So as long as he can get back in that groove with the next batter, he's not going to worry too much about it.
Into the box, Zach Plesac. They'll run this one in on him, and he can't connect, so he finds himself down 1-2 now.
Boy, that's a jam shot right there. That's as good as it gets, in my opinion. Woo, up and in.
Here comes the 1-2. It's a wave and a miss. He struck him out. One left for the Tribe. Halfway home, still no score. Set now for the bottom of the fifth, and standing in is the power-hitting second baseman, Mike Moustakas. Now the 1-1 pitch is taken for ball two. And right into the shift. He's got it. And there's one away. So one down, no one aboard. And that'll bring up Nick Senzel. Changed up on him and dropped it in for a called strike. No runs, just one hit, and no errors in the game for Cincinnati thus far. A swing and a high drive to right center field. Center fielder going back, and this ball is gone. No chance to make a play on that one. It's a solo home run for Nick Senzel. Second home run early in the year. As the Reds strike first, it's 1-0.
Hey, every once in a while, the speed guy will jump up and bite one. He absolutely crushed that baseball. Doesn't fit his usual tool description, but he can go deep if you leave one over the heart of the plate.
In now, Jonathan India. And he checks his swing. Did he go around? Yes, says the first base umpire. Strike two. Both teams with just two hits apiece thus far. Misses. Ball two. A bouncer to the left side. Scooped up. Throw gets him. Two down. So the bases are empty here with two gone. And next to bat will be Tucker Barnhart. Now the 2-1 pitch. Line to the right side. And that finds some outfield grass. It's a base hit.
And they keep the inning alive with a base hit, but you can see that's only the third hit he's given up the entire game, so he's still in total control out there.
To the plate now, Tyler Molly. And a check swing here as he couldn't help himself, and it's ruled strike two. Barnhart leads off first with a pair of outs in the inning. Still one and two as he fouls it away. Hoping to send him packing. Pitch on its way. Now a fastball, but that's easy to lay off, and it's back to even at two and two. Protecting with two strikes. Went out of the zone that time, but he stays alive. 2-2. And it's fouled away. On the eighth pitch of the at-bat is the one that finally does it as he wears him down and the inning is over. But the Reds hit the scoreboard first on this solo homer. Through five innings, it's now 1-0 Reds. New inning set to get underway, and set to go is the second baseman, Cesar Hernandez. The 1-1 home drops one down here, and he'll try to beat it out. But a foul ball, 1-2 now. Now the pitch. That's lifted the other way out to left. Winker is right there as he puts it away. No problem for the first down. Now at the plate, here is Harold Ramirez. It was a walk in his last trip. And a good spot for that pitch is it's chopped foul. To two balls and two strikes now.
Two balls, two strikes.
One out, nobody on. Hit back up the middle. On to first, and there are two down. Digging in, the switch hitter, Jose Ramirez. He's hitless in his two at-bats so far. Two out, nobody on. Two and one to Jose Ramirez.
Sitting in a good spot right here. Two ball, one strike count is yet to see a fastball. Have to be sitting on one right here.
Hey! Two and two. Out in front as he rolls over it to second. Moustakas is there. Throw on to Votto will take care of him at first, and the side is retired. So they're held in check here this half of the inning. Top of the order due up in the home half of the sixth. The Reds lead it 1-0. bottom of the sixth inning now, and next to bat will be the outfielder, Nicholas Castellanos. Breaking ball that time that misses out of the zone.
You know, what I'm seeing here is a reluctance to throw the fastball. It's like he feels he can't throw the ball right by him right now.
Fouled away.
He's got that certainly timed up now. I'd be shocked if the pitcher goes to the well three times in a row with off speed.
Swing and a miss on the fastball, and that's the first out.
Well, this lineup obviously doesn't get to see this guy very often because he's over in the other league, and it's really showing. He's pitching really well right now, and I'm sure these hitters are plenty happy they don't have to face him multiple times this year.
Into the box now, Jesse Winker. Soft liner to the right side. In time to first, and there are two away. In is Joey Votto now. It was a flyout for him in his last trip. Now the 1-1 pitch. Misses for the second ball.
Very impressive outing so far. His command has been spot on. Even when he misses his spot, it isn't out over the heart of the plate. He's throwing quality pitches.
He's fallen behind now, 3-1. Eugenio Suarez would be next if they can keep this inning alive. Bases are empty here with two men out. Lofted in the air out toward right center. Reyes is under it, and he makes the catch for out number three. 1-2-3 go the Reds. They lead it 1-0. Cam Bedrosian is on to pitch from the bullpen now to start inning number seven.
Number 46, Cam Bedrosian.
Seventh inning ready to roll, and standing in the outfielder, Franmil Reyes. The 1-2.
This is why the manager pencils these guys in the middle of the order. Big spot, time for them to get back in this game with a couple quality ABs.
A swing and a miss on a ball way out of the zone, and there's one away.
Nice job there taking care of the leadoff hitter via the strikeout. I'll tell you, in a one-run game, especially this late, getting that first guy in the inning is so important. It changes the whole complexion of the inning, so that was a big out.
So now to the plate, Eddie Rosario. A bouncer to the left side. Throw on the first will get him. Scored at 5-3 on the putout, though it looked more like a 6-3 ground ball. Nevertheless, there are two away now. So stepping in is Josh Naylor. He went down on strikes in his last at-bat. Hit fairly well out towards straightaway center. Senzel makes the play, and the side is retired. Down in order go the Tribe. They still trail 1-0. Last half of the seventh here, and set to go is the third baseman, Eugenio Suarez. Now the 2-1. Hit on the ground down the first baseline, but this will wind up a foul ball. 2-2. popped him up. Hernandez will wait on it. And he's got it for the first down. Now at the plate, Mike Moustakas grounded out in his last at bat. Good swing on a tough pitch, and he'll stick around to see another one. Making him sweat out there, the seventh pitch coming up. Fouled off. Loud contact there, but it's well fouled.
Hey, this is a heck of a battle right here. Long AB. You know what? They find themselves still facing the starter. If they would have had some ABs like this earlier in the game, I think they get into the bullpen by this time.
Once again, a 3-2. And this misses here for ball four. Just the second walk he's issued here into his seventh inning of work.
Well, when you go with a slider there in a full count, you're hoping that the hitter is thinking fastball and swings through it. Didn't work out that way, though. He lays off and gets the free pass.
Nick Senzel back at the plate now, and he's been the entire offense so far with the solo homer he hit earlier. The 2-1 pitch. Late swing there at the breaking ball. Must have been looking for something else. Fastball is outside, and it's full now, 3-2.
Keep in mind, people, the longer the at-bat, the higher the likelihood that this becomes his last inning.
Count still full, 3-2. Oh, it's on the ground to second. Did he get his double play? The second for one. On to first as they get the double play to get him out of the inning. Reds go down quietly, but they lead it 1-0. Lucas Sims has been summoned from the bullpen as he'll do so to start the eighth.
Number 39, Lucas Sims.
Ready to begin the eighth, and stepping up as the shortstop, Andrés Giménez. And that misses, 2-1. Now action in the bullpen as their closer starts to get loose out there. Shot to third and handled for the first out. Next to hit is Austin Hedges. Lifetime against this particular arm. Not a big sample size, 0-1. He's set. Here comes the 1-1.
Full exercise.
Bases are empty, one man out. Bounce to first, fielded by Votto, and there are two away now. Ben Gamel will pinch hit here, and he's the potential tying run. Now the 1-1 pitch misses, ball two. And he's really given some leeway on the outside edge here. 2-2 now.
That pitch looked like it could have been a little high, but he's been calling that pitch all night. Kind of rough for a pinch hitter, but I'm sure his teammates let him know that's where the zone has been.
Got him swinging, and that's the third out. Indians go down 1-2-3. They're on the short end of a 1-0 score. Phil Maton is on to pitch out of the bullpen in the bottom half of the eighth.
Number 88, Phil Maton.
Jonathan India digging in now. He was retired via the ground ball last time up. This is on the ground over to first. Reined in. And the throw to first is in time. One gone. And there are the final numbers for the Indian starter. He was on point from the get-go this evening.
Hey, only allowed 3 hits in this one. Kept the hitters off balance and was a lot of fun to watch.
Standing in now, Tucker Barnhart. No offer on that one. 2 balls and a strike. His prior history in this matchup, he's hitless in 3 at-bats. Two balls and 2 strikes to the Reds catcher. Still 2-2. 1 out, nobody on. Here's a swing and a long drive high in the air and deep to center field. And that'll get down out there near the wall. He hit the corner and tries for third. And he's in there at third with a 1-out triple.
In most parts of the league, that would be a round tripper. Now I mean, he hits this thing probably more than 400 feet, but he'll have to be content with a triple. Yeah. Has to feel good about the way he hit it, though.
Tyler Naquin will grab a bat and pinch hit now, and he'll be looking for at least a fly ball as he's got a runner at third and only 1 away. Now the payoff pitch home. Drilled right back up the middle. And that'll get past his outstretched glove. It's a base hit. And the insurance run comes across to score from third.
Dan, that's a huge insurance run right there. Has to feel good as a hitter right there to not only get a ribby knock, but to give your team a little bit of breathing room.
It does, and to make your pitcher go out there with a little bit more free and easy frame of mind instead of going in a 1-1 game where every pitch is so important. You're 1 pitch away from a solo tying the game up. That's not the case now.
And, oh, that should have been ball 4 there, but it's a called strike, and that runs things full at 3-2.
I think it's a real possibility that they put that run on first in motion. That would help them stay out of that double play that would end the inning, but that's also kind of risky at the same time.
Now the 3-2 pitch. A swing and a shot hit down the corner. And he just couldn't keep that ball fair as it winds up a long foul ball.
That's a shame right there. Foul home run would have given his team the lead. Has to be able to refocus, recalibrate, set his sights on something over those 17 inches.
Another full count pitch home. Oh, it's on the ground to second. Did he get his double play? One there. On to first. Not in time as the umpire was right there to make the call. Now it'll be Jesse Winker. Lifetime against this pitcher. Small sample, a perfect 1-for-1. There's a fastball well off the plate for a ball. Goes the other way as this is lined to left. Rosario gets under it and makes the catch to end the inning. It's a run on 2 hits here for Cincinnati. Sean Doolittle comes out of the bullpen to shut things down here in the ninth.
Number 63. Sean Doolittle.
Cesar Hernandez will be the first one to greet him, as he'll have to turn around and bat from the right side of the plate here.
Yeah, it's always a nightmare taking on another team's closer trying to get back into a game, especially in the ninth inning. But having your leadoff guy up to start that inning is as good as you could have hoped for. So let's see if he can get something started here.
Again, he sends it out of play. Another 2-2 offering. Swing and a liner. But this is going to be a foul ball, as that keeps things at 2-2. Swung on in the dirt for the third strike. And he makes the throw to first. Hernandez is retired, and there's one away.
When your closer comes in and strikes out the first guy he faces, everyone on the team can kind of take a deep breath. Still have two more outs to get, but retiring that leadoff guy is always huge when you're trying to shut a game down.
Now a swing and a softly hit ground ball. Bases are empty, one man out. And they come inside with the fastball, but it misses here, and it's back to 2-2. Just staying alive, putting together a really good at-bat here. Two-two one more time. He is swung on and missed. He got him.
No problems for him on the mound since he's come out of the pen to start this inning. That's back-to-back K's, and he's making it look pretty easy. This has the makings of a good outing so far.
At the plate, Jose Ramirez. And this one misses inside, a ball he walked him, and they've got themselves a two-out base runner.
That is just a great at-bat there. When you're down late, you need base runners any way you can get them, and that never-say-die mentality could be the difference. We'll see how it plays out.
So next, it'll be the four-hole hitter for the Tribe, Franmil Reyes. He's 0-for-2 with a strikeout in this one. Now the 1-1 pitch.
Nope.
Swing and a line drive to center field, and that'll get down for a base hit. So he waited till the ninth inning, but he comes through here to extend the hit streak. That was close.
Yeah, Matty B, you see that wry smile of him coming out of the box right there? He knew what was on the line. He'd be lying if he didn't.
There's a lot of pressure on you because you're walking into that batter's box thinking, I have a nice streak going, and this is more than likely going to be my last AB. He comes through in the clutch.
Next to stand in is Eddie Rosario, and his guys are looking to erase that donut on the scoreboard with a runner in scoring position.
Yeah, Matt, they've been really shut down so far in this one. They've had runners on base, but haven't been able to string anything together.
Taken called strike two, and now they're down to their final strike tonight. And now this crowd, a bit over 30,000 strong, comes to their feet. Now a swing and a ground ball. This should do it. Throw on the second for the force, and the ball game is over.
Always nice to get the first game of a series, but even more so when it's in front of the home crowd. Seems to energize everybody the rest of the series.
This evening's game finishes 2-0 the final score. Cincinnati used a nice fifth inning to take the lead, and they never gave it back. Tyler Mahle gets the win on the mound, his first of the year, permitting only two hits in six complete innings. Zach Plesac is settled with a loss after giving up only one earned. Sean Doolittle earns the save out of the bullpen, his third of the campaign. So that's a wrap for us here tonight. For my partners in the booth, Mark DeRosa and Dan Plesac, and Heidi Watney on the field, this is Matt Vasgersian. You've been watching MLB Network. Have a good night, everybody.
The final line score for our ball game tonight: for the victorious Cincinnati Reds, 2 runs on 5 hits, no errors, they left 5 men on base. For Cleveland, 0 runs, 3 hits, no errors, they left 6 men on base. Time of the ball game: 2 hours and 29 minutes. Thank you for joining us here this evening. We remind you to please drive home safely.